magnetic effect of current. So now, what do you mean by magnetic effect of current? So the magnetic field produced due to current is called magnetic effect of current. So what do you mean by magnetic effect of current here? Magnetic effect of current means a current carrying wire produces magnetic field around it. And this magnetic effect of current was proposed by Hans Oersted. This was proposed by Hans Oersted. The scientist. Okay, who proposed the magnetic effect of current? So the magnetic effect of current was proposed by Hans Oersted. So what is said? He said that every current carrying produces magnetic field around it. Then how he concluded the magnetic field produces around the current carrying conductor or current carrying wire. So there is an experiment. What is that experiment? So here magnetic effect of current is also called electromagnetism. Why it is called electromagnetism here? Here the magnetic field is produced due to electricity. Electricity means here the current. So magnetic field is produced due to the current is called electromagnetism, and also it is called magnetic effect of current. So what about the Oersted experiment? In his experiment, he used a circuit. What is that circuit? That circuit carrying current, that is I. So now let us take what is this? It is nothing but battery. And this battery is connected to a wire along with a key. So it is a key. And there is a rheostat. What is the use of rheostat here? To vary the current without changing its voltage. Okay. So next, it is a conducting wire. I will take this conducting wire as X1. So whenever there is a flow of current through this conducting wire, this is the direction of flow of current. What is the direction of flow of current here? Already we know that the direction of flow of current from positive to negative. So whenever we are going to place a magnetic needle or magnetic compass needle near to the current carrying wire, that magnetic compass needle shows a deflection. When the magnetic compass needle shows a deflection, only then that magnetic compass needle is placed in the magnetic field. Okay. So now let us take it is a magnetic compass needle. That magnetic compass needle having two poles. That needle having two poles, north pole and south pole. This arrow is north and this tail is nothing but south. Now it shows a deflection. If there is no current in the wire, if there is no flow of current in the wire, there is no deflection produced in the magnetic compass needle. Okay. So what it is showing now, if the magnetic compass needle shows a deflection, means there is a magnetic field around this wire because of current in this wire. If I will make the current in this wire is zero, there is no deflection shown in the magnetic compass needle. Suppose I will reverse the direction of current, again there is a deflection shown in the magnetic compass needle, but in opposite direction. Means on reversing the direction of current, there is a reversing direction of magnetic field. Okay. So it is the Oersted experiment. What about Oersted experiment here? Whenever there is a flow of current through the wire, we are going to place a magnetic compass needle near to the wire. That magnetic compass needle shows the deflection. Why? Because here then the magnetic field produced around the wire because of current in the wire. If there is no current in the wire, there is no magnetic, sorry, there is no deflection produced in the magnetic compass needle. If there is no deflection produced in the magnetic compass needle, there is no magnetic field produced around the wire. Yes, what is the cause of magnetic field around the wire? That is current in the wire. So it is an suggested experiment. Next we are going to discuss that magnet. What is magnet? Magnet is an object which attracts the pieces of some materials like iron, nickel, cobalt. So what is magnet here? Magnet is an object. Magnet is an object which attracts other use of the magnet. In case of speakers, there is a round shaped magnet used that can attract the pieces of iron, nickel and cobalt. So magnet is an object which attracts the materials like those materials are called ferromagnetic materials. The materials which are strongly attracted by magnet, those materials are called ferromagnetic materials. For example, for the ferromagnetic material, iron, nickel and cobalt, these are the ferromagnetic materials. And some materials are there, those materials are weakly repelled by magnet. Those materials are called diamagnetic materials. What are those materials? Diamagnetic materials. For example, gold, water, these are the example for diamagnetic materials, because these materials are repelled by the magnet. Okay. So now, but here, magnet, what is magnet? Magnet is an object which attracts the materials like, what are those materials? Iron, nickel, cobalt and etc. It is called magnet. Okay. And what do you mean by magnetic field? Magnetic field is that it is a space surrounding the magnet in which the force of attraction or the force of repulsion exerted on the material. Okay. Force of attraction exerted on which type of material? That is ferromagnetic material. But the force of repulsion is exerted on which material? That is diamagnetic material. That space around the magnet. In that space, the material experiences force. Okay. That space is called magnetic field. What do you mean by magnetic field now? Magnetic field. So what is magnetic field here? It is this space or region. Around a magnet. For example, so around the earth, which field is there? Gravitational field is there. Because in this field, an object can experience the gravitational force. Okay. So around the earth, which field is there? Gravitational field is there. In this region, in this space or in this field, an object can experience the which type of force? Gravitational force. But here, it is the space or region around the magnet in which a material experiences force. Which type of force? Magnetic force. Whether it is attractive or repulsive, depending on the nature of the material. So if it is a ferromagnetic material, then which type of force acting on that material? That is attractive. If it is a diamagnetic material, which type of force acting on that material? That is repulsive. Okay. So it is a space or region around the magnet in which a force of attraction this force of attraction is exerted on which type of material? Ferromagnetic material. The force of attraction or the force force of repulsion. Exactly. Is called magnetic field. Is called magnetic field. So, what is magnetic field here? It is the space or region around the magnet or around a current carrying wire, because current carrying wire also produces magnetic field. Magnet also produces magnetic field. If we are going to place a ferromagnetic material in the magnetic field of the current carrying wire, okay, in the magnetic field of the current carrying wire, it experiences which type of force? That is attractive force. If we place the diamagnetic material, it experiences which type of force? That is a repulsive force. Means there is a field around the wire. That field is called magnetic field. See, suppose to be, I will take it as a magnet. And the magnet having two poles, okay, they occur in field north and south. So whenever they are going to bring the ferromagnetic material near to the north or near to the magnet, it is strongly attracted by the magnet. So because it is a which type of material? Ferromagnetic material. If it experiences force, means there is a magnetic field around this magnet, okay. So why it experiences force here? Because there is a magnetic field produced around the magnet. And if I will bring the diamagnetic material, but that diamagnetic material should be repelled by this magnet. Because whenever we are going to bring the magnetic material in the magnetic field of the magnet, it experiences which type of force? Repulsive force. Means there is a magnetic field around the magnet. Then next we are going to discuss the magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines. Then what are magnetic field lines? So these are the imaginary lines drawn in the magnetic field of the magnet. So along which the magnetic north pole tends to move. Okay. So what are magnetic field lines here? These are the imaginary lines. These are the imaginary lines. Why these are called imaginary lines? Because we can't see these lines, but we can see the path made by the north pole of the magnet. Okay. These are the imaginary lines drawn in magnetic field of the magnet or magnetic field of the current carrying wire. Drawn in magnetic field along which a magnetic north pole tends to move. Magnetic north pole move. Okay. So what are the magnetic field lines here? These are the imaginary lines drawn in magnetic field along which a magnetic north pole moves. See here. It is north and it is south. I will bring a magnetic north pole, but here monopole is not exist. So monopole is not exist. Single pole is not exist, because in case of a magnet, always two poles are operating pair. They never be single. They never be single means here north never be single, south never be single. North and south always opposing pair. Just imagine there is a north pole present. Okay. There is a monopole present. Just imagine to understand this concept. Suppose I will bring a north pole here. Okay. So now this north pole tends to move along the imaginary path from north to south. This imaginary line is called magnetic field line. Okay. So what is magnetic field line here? It is the imaginary line drawn in the magnetic field along which a magnetic north pole tends to move, or a magnetic north pole moves. This imaginary line is nothing but it is the path made by the magnetic north pole in the magnetic field. This imaginary line is called magnetic field line. So magnetic field lines also called as lines of force of magnetic field. Then what are the properties of magnetic field lines? So what is the direction of magnetic field here? From where to where the magnetic north pole moves here? From north pole of the ball magnet to the south pole of the magnet. Okay. So what is the direction of magnetic field? That is from north to south, but it is outside the magnet. But inside the magnet, it is south to north. So just remember this one. What is the direction of magnetic field outside the magnet? That is from north to south. But inside the magnet, that is from south to north. Because magnetic field lines form closed loops or closed curves. Okay. So what are the properties of magnetic field lines? So what are those properties? So first property is that the direction of magnetic field is from north to south. The direction of magnetic field. The direction of magnetic field from north to south pole of the magnet. Okay. So next. The magnetic field lines form closed curves, means they form closed loops. It is a closed loop. Here also, it is a closed loop. But inside the magnet, what is the direction of magnetic field? Inside the magnet, the direction of magnetic field from south to north. But outside the magnetic field, that is from north to south. North to south. Okay. Next, they form magnetic field lines always for closed loops. They form closed loops. And third one, the magnetic field lines never intersect each other. Means one magnetic field line do not cross over the another magnetic field line, because there is a unique direction for the magnetic field, that is from north to south. Okay. So, two magnetic field lines never intersect each other. Magnetic field lines never intersect. Means never cross. One magnetic field line does not cross over the another magnetic field line. Okay. The magnetic field having the unique direction. So, two magnetic field lines never cross each other. Why? Because the magnetic field having the unique direction. Unique direction means here, single direction, that is from north to south. Never cross each other. Next. So, the reason in which the magnetic field lines are close, in that reason magnetic field is strong. So, in which reason the magnetic field lines are close here? Near to the magnet. Okay, near to the end of the magnetic field lines are close to each other. In that reason, magnetic field is strong. And where the magnetic field lines are well apart, means farther apart, means well separated. In that reason, magnetic field is weak. See here the magnetic field lines is farther apart, means well separated here. Here the magnetic field is weak. But here, the magnetic field lines are closely spaced. Here the magnetic field is strong. So, the reason in which the magnetic field lines are closely spaced, in that reason the magnetic field is strong. Where the magnetic field is strong, that is near to the end of the magnet. And where the magnetic field is weak here, magnetic field is weak where the magnetic field lines are further apart. Okay. Then next one, last one. So, the direction of magnetic field is shown by the tangent drawn to the magnetic field line. I will draw the tangent here. This is tangent This tangent shows the direction of magnetic field. That is from where to where? That is from north to south. Okay. So by knowing the direction of motion of the magnetic north pole, we can determine the direction of magnetic field. That is from north pole of the magnet to the south pole of the magnet. So we are going to show that direction by using tangent. A tangent drawn to the magnetic field line shows the direction of magnetic field. And one more is that uniform magnetic field. What do you mean by uniform magnetic field here? The magnetic field lines are parallel to each other and the equidistance between them. See, the magnetic field lines parallel to each other and equidistance between them. Equidistance between them. So this magnetic field is called uniform magnetic field. So this is about the magnetic field lines and properties of magnetic field lines and also magnet and also what do you mean by magnetic effect of current. Okay. So one more thing, like poles always repel each other. Like poles means north and north. Like means same. Same poles always repel each other, but unlike poles attract each other. Unlike poles means different poles. North and south, they always attract each other. Okay, you have to remember.